The PeopleSoft Fluid WorkCenter Framework provides a central place for completion of work and activities. This simplifies user navigation and provides an intuitive dashboard for running queries and reports. Payroll for North America and Global Payroll are previously delivered WorkCenters that use the PeopleSoft Fluid Framework. Now, Benefits and Time and Labor are using the same framework to modernize the user interface. And this is just the starting point. The Fluid WorkCenter is configurable to meet your specific needs by role and business unit. Add or delete work items, links, queries, and reports to make the WorkCenter more efficient for your administrative users and managers. Notice that the My Work section of the Benefits WorkCenter has 7 new exception queries. The No Social Security Number Dependent Health query provides you with a list of employees who have dependents missing Social Security numbers. Selecting an employee ID opens the Dependent Beneficiary page where you can directly add the Social Security number to the dependent. Or, you can use the related actions to go directly to the Benefits Summary page or send a notification to the employee. My Work queries are executed every time you open the page or refresh. If a work item query doesn't find any results, the link is grayed out. Use links to access commonly used pages. The delivered links provide you with an example of what is possible. Later in this video, we'll demonstrate how you can easily add links that are important to you. The links can be grouped and moved for your preference. You can run queries, reports, and other processes without leaving the WorkCenter. And, for easy access, the WorkCenter offers you a section to place the many queries and reports you've created for your benefits business processes. 2 new roles have been delivered for Benefits WorkCenter. First, a Benefits Specialist role that does not include links to the Benefits Setup pages, as these are more commonly controlled by the Benefits Administrator. And an ACA Specialist role that is more involved with tasks and reporting on the Affordable Care Act. Now we'll review the Time and Labor WorkCenter and its distinctive features. The My Work section of the Time and Labor WorkCenter contains Pagelets to help managers and administrators manage their workload. The Alerts group contains 7 types that your organization has set up. Alerts are generated when the alerts process is run. Managers and administrators can take action on the alert or view the details using the related actions. And you can also take bulk actions by selecting multiple rows that you want to act on, and then choose an action. You can view the exceptions generated by the time administration process in the WorkCenter. The actions permit you to allow or manage the exception. Fluid AWE approvals are also a My Work item. You can view and manage approvals as if you were accessing them from the Approvals tile. The Time Reporter Status Work item can display time reporters with a status of not up for processing, in process, or up for processing. Use the Scope functionality to set the filter. Attendance items are created if the attendance programs are set up. Attendance violations show when a time reporter punched in early or late, either to their shift or one or more breaks. Attendance actions result from the accumulation of points associated with attendance violations. Use related actions to send notifications about the items. Because Fluid WorkCenters are a framework that can be used across products, many of the features are very similar. Let's review some of the core functionality that is common to all WorkCenters. Administrators can control configuration of the WorkCenter through the Configure Pagelets pages, under WorkCenter Dashboards, in Enterprise Components. The administrator also can control the order of the grouplets and whether they are collapsed or not when the page opens. PeopleSoft Delivered WorkCenters contain predefined pagelets in the My Work section to help you identify items that may need attention. On the Pagelet Configuration page, define work items, set up scope security, determine whether to show it on a mobile phone or to show it as a link. You can also set up filters. For all sections, the administrator can allow users to personalize the content. Administrators can configure links to allow you to add your own personal links. You'll need to add a new group and then define your links. For queries, administrators can define whether to show the Query Manager View link in the WorkCenter. In the Queries section, Administrators can also choose to add queries or pivot grids and determine the access to those items. On the Reports Processes tab, you can define which menu items or URLs to display. If the administrator allows user personalization, the managers, specialists, or anyone who accesses the WorkCenter can access it more efficiently and tailor it for their own work preferences. As a user, choose whether to display the My Work section collapsed when the WorkCenter opens, allowing more room for frequently used sections. Refine the collapsing of groups within a section by selecting the Start Group Collapsed checkbox for individual My Work groups. Reorder the work items by dragging and dropping to the place that is better suited for your workflow. Show Count allows you to see the number of items that are in your query. If you're running a very large query that may return large amounts of items, you may want to take the count off to save processing time. In this example, the show count is not checked for the preparation and election error, as the number of exceptions could be very large during a benefits open enrollment period. The starting page allows you to choose the work item to be highlighted when you first enter the WorkCenter. The links tabs enable you to add groups so you can easily add and organize your favorite links. For example, as a benefits administrator, you may want to add links to your third-party vendors. Drop down and select the link type. Copy in your URL and label and select Done. You now see your new link. You can reorder the group by dragging and dropping. Save your locations when you're done. Reports and processes can include a menu item or a URL. Select Add Group to define it. Like the Links section, you can define whether the item should be opened in a new window or not. The Personalization feature for Queries and Reports and Processes sections works like the Links section, providing you with robust functionality for adding your own queries and reports that you've collected over the years. Scope is a high-level filter that allows you to define your work items. Use the filters to separate your work by business unit, department, company, date, and a few other fields. The Maintain Scope Detail allows you to edit the filters. Administrators can limit scope capabilities for individual users. For example, you can limit the scope of items returned in the work item reports by choosing one of these fields. By selecting Employee ID Begins with KU, your query for employees missing a social security number returns the exceptions for employees that begin with KU, limiting your search. The scope does require some setup, as each query can be filtered differently. You can also create additional scopes and filter exception reports differently. Again, just another way to segregate and personalize the data. The Fluid WorkCenters that PeopleSoft delivers are a starting point for your organization to build a WorkCenter based on your policies and processes, and that your individual users can configure to meet their preferences. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.